Hi, I'm Brian with KISSmetrics, and I'm here to help you get the most out of your Google Analytics account. Every time I dig into Google Analytics, I find another feature that I had no idea even existed. For example, just the other day, I was messing around in my Google Analytics account and ran across a cool feature that allows you to see a color-coded version of your page that has overlays on it that shows you how many clicks that have happened on each link on the site. It shows you browser size data, and you can use all that to optimize the page for the highest conversion rates. I'm going to tell you all about that feature and two other really cool features that I had no idea existed in this week's episode. So, let's get going. Everybody constantly talks about going mobile. Every expert you read, listen to, or watch says you must have a mobily optimized version of your website. But what if 99% of your traffic comes from desktop users? Does it make sense then to invest the time, money, and effort that it takes to develop that site? How would you know if you've never looked? If you've never looked at the statistics and measured that, how do you know whether that's a good decision to make or not? Google Analytics gives you a super easy way to find that out. Just navigate to your profile page and click Behavior and then Mobile. From here, you can do two things. The most obvious is the number of visitors. Here I can see I've had a total of 3,459 visitors in this time period. Of those, 2,656 are from desktops and 803 are from phones and tablets. Roughly 23% of my traffic is coming from mobile devices. That's a quarter of all my traffic comes from mobile. The second thing you can see is your bounce rate. Bounce rate is simply the number of people that leave your site after only seeing one page. If your percentage is substantially higher on mobile devices, then that could be an indication that you need to optimize the existing mobile page or install a new one. So you need to pay attention to two specific things: the percentage of your visitors that are viewing your site on mobile devices. If that's a high number, then pay attention. If it's a very low number, if 1% of your visitors are coming from that, it shouldn't be on your radar. The second key indicator is your bounce rate. Are people that view your website on mobile devices more likely to leave the page than those that are viewing on desktop devices? If that's the case, then you need to pay attention. You need to have a mobile optimized site. You need to constantly tweak it for those users so they don't leave your website. All right, another cool feature that Google Analytics has that I had no idea about, and I'm probably the last person on the planet that didn't know about this, but I just found it a few months ago, and it's the ability to see your top performing content on your website. The first thing you'll want to do is to navigate to your profile page. Then find Behavior in the left-hand sidebar and click on Site Content and then All Pages. This will show you every page on your website that has been visited, defaultly sorted by page views. You can also sort the list by average time on page to see what content kept your visitors on the site for the longest. This can help you produce more content that people will like in the future. Lastly, Google Analytics gives you a super cool way to visualize how your visitors interact with your website. They call it in-page analytics. In order to set it up, just go to your profile page, scroll to the bottom and click on Behavior, and then in-page analytics. From here, you can display multiple options. Use the drop-down box on the left-hand side to choose what data you want to display. You can show link click information, you can show your goal values and conversion funnels. You can also adjust how the data is displayed with the Show Bubbles and Show Colors button. Lastly, you can visualize how your customers see your website with their specific browser size. All of this can help you visually see what parts of your website are the most popular, which ones are getting the most clicks. And you can use this to help you so when you put out a new piece of content, you can know what part of the website to put it on so your visitors will be more likely to interact with it and to read it. So those are the three cool new tricks that I've learned in the last few weeks with Google Analytics. If you have something that everybody else may not know about, if you have a cool trick that you use with Google Analytics that might be buried in the software somewhere, share it with the community below so we can all benefit from it. So that's it for this week. Until next time, happy analyticing.